What is the relationship between Turkey and Russia? How does this relationship affect Turkey's position within the EU? What should we expect in the future? And how should EU and Turkey deal with Russia? Hello and welcome to TEPSA Explainers. My name is Cana Tülüş Türk and I'm Research and Administrative Affairs Coordinator at Istanbul Policy Center and PhD candidate in Political Science. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Turkey-Russia relations and the West. There is one main point that I would like you to take after watching this video is that the relations between Turkey and Russia can be thought of as a pendulum swinging from conflict and compromise and back, depending on their colliding and overlapping interests in different issues. Historically, the two countries have been strategic partners in terms of their military, economic, and political interests, but never close allies. While current relations are stronger than ever, they have been transactional, compartmentalized, and asymmetrically in favor of Russia, more highly personalized and than institutionalized. So, I would like to clarify those points in detail. First, historical relations. Especially after the fall of the Soviet Union, the rapid increase in economic relations created a new phase in relations. While economic cooperation worked well in specific relations, such as energy and trade, cooperation has been limited on some political issues. As such, bilateral relations over the last two decades have been followed the strategy of compartmentalization, in which the two countries focus on areas of cooperation and leave conflictual issues untouched. Second, economic cooperation is the driving force behind relations based on energy, agriculture, tourism, housing, and construction. Turkey and Russia have been continuing bilateral trade partners, with Russia being Turkey's third largest import and 10th largest export partner. The main components of Russian exports to Turkey are refined and crude petroleum, along with wheat. Russia is the largest supplier of natural gas to Turkey as well. However, economic relations are termed as asymmetric, since they are mostly one-sided, with the balance very much towards the Russian side. Third, politics. Another indication of developing relations is the close political dialogue between Erdogan and Putin. From all the conflicts in the last two decades, the two leaders have found ways to solve bilateral issues through personal decision-making processes and initiatives despite having different objectives. Yet, as the most important difference between Turkey relations with the West and with Russia, no institutional basis exists in Turkey-Russia relations. This transactional and not institutionalized cooperation still has its limits when the conflict comes to regions close to Russia, such as the Black Sea region and South Caucasus. For instance, when the issue is Ukraine, Georgia, and Nagorno-Karabakh, the two countries prefer following their interests, reflecting their regional ambitions. Furthermore, the lack of institutionalization in bilateral relations and personal decision-making processes bring volatility to the relationship, as well as trust problems and skepticism, which prevents the two countries from becoming close allies. And personal rapport has its limits, leaving ambiguity in the future of the post-Putin era. Recently, Turkey has tried to find a balance in its foreign affairs, alternatives for easing its economic and political dependence, and new ways to overcome its asymmetric interdependence, as well as its now vulnerability to Russia. In economic relations, Turkey has sought to diversify its natural gas resources, and hence, Russian gas imports have been declining over the last 2 years. In politics, Turkey's stance in the Ukrainian war and its position in the Georgian conflict can also be seen as a strategy to counter the Russian dominance in part of the EU's neighborhood. So, what can be done? While Turkey's resentment of the West has been the driving force behind its rapprochement with Russia, it's likely that future relations between Turkey and Russia will be limited to areas in which their interests overlap. The war in Ukraine and the war between Azerbaijan and Armenia have shown the limits of Turkey-Russia cooperation and the strategic importance of Turkey for the West. So, Turkey's geostrategic importance as the EU's neighbor, especially in the Black Sea region, gives Turkey an important balancing role that the West needs in its energy and security agenda. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and follow us for more videos, and stay tuned for the next TEPSA explainer.